In today's video, we'll be discussing why your chronic fatigue may be linked to diabetes. Our goal is to help you understand the connection between these two conditions, and we're going to provide insights into how managing one can help to improve the other. Chronic fatigue is a debilitating condition that affects millions of people worldwide. Suffering from chronic fatigue means experiencing overwhelming tiredness, exhaustion, frustration, and a persistent state of weariness. The truth is that, in multiple ways, diabetes can directly lead to chronic fatigue. But how exactly? And why is your blood sugar control so closely related to your energy, or lack thereof? Stay tuned as we delve deeper into this fascinating and important connection between chronic fatigue and diabetes. Plus, we'll reveal the proven methods which work to manage both conditions simultaneously. This is why your chronic fatigue may be linked to diabetes. Chronic fatigue. It can feel like a heavy weight on your shoulders, constantly dragging you down and preventing you from fully enjoying and participating in your daily life. Chronic fatigue not only impacts your physical well-being, it can take a toll on your mental health. But how does this tiring condition relate to diabetes exactly? And why did studies involving diabetic participants show that improvements to their blood sugar control led to improvements in their energy levels? Let's break down 7 main reasons why your chronic fatigue may be linked to your blood sugar management. Reason number 1, high and low blood sugar and insulin resistance. High blood sugar, otherwise known as hyperglycemia, occurs when there is too much glucose floating through the bloodstream. This can happen to you if your pancreas does not produce enough insulin, or if your muscle cells have become resistant to insulin, as is the case for type 2 diabetics. The exact mechanisms behind the link between hyperglycemia and chronic fatigue are not yet fully understood, but researchers believe it may be due to the effect of high blood sugar on the brain and nervous system. And research suggests that elevated blood sugar can literally overwhelm and exhaust your body as it attempts to process and store the excess glucose. High blood sugar can also increase your risk of oxidative stress and inflammation. This can damage your brain cells and neurotransmitters, which may impair your brain function, mood, and energy levels. Chronic high blood sugar levels may also lead to diabetic neuropathy, which damages nerves and tissues in the legs and feet. This too can increase fatigue. Hyperglycemia can also impact your immune system and may increase the risk of bacterial or viral infections. Of course, getting hit with an illness like that can also dramatically increase your feelings of fatigue. Hypoglycemia, on the other hand, means that there is too little glucose in the bloodstream. Though this occurrence is more associated with type 1 diabetes, it can also affect type 2 diabetics. In fact, studies have found that approximately 25% of type 2 diabetics who have taken prescription insulin for 5 years may experience severe hypoglycemia. And not having enough glucose in your bloodstream means that your muscle cells are not receiving enough energy. So naturally, hypoglycemia can also cause feelings of fatigue. At the end of the day, or, well, many days, experiencing erratic glucose levels can create heightened levels of insulin resistance. Of course, increased insulin resistance can lead to high levels of insulin in the bloodstream. And because insulin plays a key role in energy metabolism, excess insulin in the bloodstream can create a sedative effect, leading to feelings of drowsiness and fatigue. Plus, by definition, insulin resistance means that your muscle cells have a reduced ability to utilize glucose efficiently. Therefore, your muscles may not be receiving adequate amounts of energy, which, of course, may increase feelings of fatigue. Recent research has studied the effect of hyper- and hypoglycemia and insulin resistance on levels of fatigue among the diabetic population. A study published in the journal Diabetes Care noted that type 2 diabetics more often report symptoms of chronic fatigue than those without diabetes. The study also found that high HbA1c levels were associated with greater fatigue severity. So, erratic glucose levels and heightened insulin resistance are not just the main symptoms of diabetes. They are the general reason why diabetes is so closely linked with chronic fatigue. But there are several other related issues which may be behind your exhaustion. That includes reason number two, poor circulation and diabetic neuropathy. Did you know that high blood sugar levels can damage the walls of your blood vessels? This can lead to decreased circulation, which can have the effect of reducing your digestive system's absorption of oxygen and vital nutrients. That may then lead to a buildup of waste products in your cells, which can cause fatigue and a general feeling of malaise. Plus, not only can this reduction of oxygen and nutrient absorption cause serious complications, including an increased risk of kidney disease, heart disease, stroke, and foot ulcers, it can also lead to diabetic neuropathy. This condition damages nerves and impairs muscle function, which can make it difficult to walk and can add to feelings of muscle weakness and fatigue. On top of that, when your circulation is poor, your heart must work harder to pump blood through your body. This too can increase feelings of fatigue, especially if your heart has already become weakened due to other diabetes-related symptoms. Additionally, when your brain does not receive adequate levels of oxygen and other micronutrients, it can impair your mood and cognitive function. This can lead to feelings of brain fog and a decrease in concentration, further increasing your fatigue. Reason number three, poor sleep. It sounds obvious, but as poor sleep can decrease daytime focus and alertness, then naturally it can and will most likely lead to a vicious cycle of fatigue. But what does diabetes have to do with a lack of good sleep? We've just discussed how poor circulation can lead to fatigue, so it shouldn't come as a shock to learn that diabetes-related poor circulation can also interfere with proper sleep habits. Restricted blood flow can reduce your body's ability to properly regulate your internal temperature, which can lead to night sweats and an increased inability to fall asleep. But diabetes and poor sleep are linked in several other manners as well. Poor sleep can also lead to an increase in blood sugar levels. And studies show that a regular lack of sleep can make it more difficult for type 1 and type 2 diabetics to manage their condition effectively. But on the flip side, having diabetes can lead to poor sleep, as blood sugar fluctuations during the night can cause frequent awakenings and restlessness. High blood sugar can also cause your body to produce more urine, and it can lead to an increase in the frequency of nighttime bathroom visits. Plus, diabetic neuropathy can create bothersome tingling or burning sensations in the hands and feet, which may make it more difficult for some diabetics to fall asleep or stay asleep. And even certain diabetes medications have been reported to create symptoms like insomnia and daytime drowsiness, which can interfere with quality nighttime sleep. So yes, diabetes can create poor sleep habits, and poor sleep habits can increase the risk of developing diabetes. And in either case, a chronic lack of quality sleep will most assuredly lead to chronic fatigue. Reason number four, depression and anxiety. Were you aware that upwards of 40% of diabetics have reported feelings of depression and anxiety? And obviously, feelings of depression and anxiety can also increase feelings of fatigue. Research has shown that individuals with diabetes are twice as likely to develop depression as those without diabetes, and individuals with depression have a heightened risk of developing diabetes. Studies have proven that managing diabetes can create a psychological impact, with increased levels of stress, frustration, and anxiety. Many diabetics have also reported that their feelings of anxiety concerning their condition led to a drop in their motivation for managing their glucose levels. This may then lead to a decrease in exercise, an increase in unhealthy food cravings, a risk of weight gain, an overall rise in blood sugar, and feelings of depression, which can all work to heighten feelings of fatigue. Diabetes-related depression and anxiety may also decrease your levels of quality sleep and proper nutrition, which can further increase tiredness and exhaustion. Reason number 5, dehydration. Just as diabetes can lead to poor sleep and increased anxiety, it can also lead to dehydration, which in turn can also heighten chronic fatigue. Diabetes affects your body's ability to regulate fluids, and high levels of glucose in your bloodstream will force your system to remove excess glucose via more frequent urination. Naturally, this can then lead to dehydration. And being dehydrated can create various symptoms related to increased fatigue, including dizziness, confusion, and tiredness. When your body is dehydrated, it has increased difficulty transporting oxygen through your bloodstream. From there, your muscle cells will have increased difficulty in producing adequate energy, thus resulting in tiredness and exhaustion. Plus, dehydration can cause electrolyte imbalances, which will further contribute to feelings of fatigue. What other diabetes-related factors which contribute to chronic fatigue should you watch out for? That's just ahead. But first, we're giving away 3 free gifts. Simply click the link in the description box below and you'll receive the comprehensive guidebook, Superfoods for Diabetics, episode 1 of the groundbreaking series, That Diabetes Documentary, and our new diabetes fighting cookbook, Snacks, Meals, and Desserts That Lower Blood Sugar. Just click the link below to get all 3 for free. Now, let's get back to the list with reason number 6, chronic inflammation. Inflammation is your body's natural response to an injury or an infection, and acute inflammation is necessary for maintaining proper health. However, chronic inflammation is a different matter, and it is yet another symptom of chronic high blood sugar. This type of inflammation not only increases the risk of developing type 2 diabetes, but conversely, inflammation has been found to disrupt glucose metabolism and heighten insulin resistance. It's a vicious cycle. And diabetics who experience frequent and prolonged inflammation may endure a wide range of issues, including pain, swelling, redness, and yes, fatigue. As diabetes increases inflammation in the body, that can lead to an increase of cytokines, molecules which have been linked to chronic fatigue. Plus, studies also show that chronic inflammation can lead to a condition known as chronic fatigue syndrome, or CFS. Inflammation contributes to the development of CFS by causing an imbalance in certain energy-related hormones and neurotransmitters. This disruption in energy production can lead to feelings of tiredness and exhaustion, even after a good night's sleep. Meanwhile, chronic high blood sugar can increase the risk of cell-damaging oxidative stress, and research shows that oxidative stress can also contribute to inflammation, which in turn may lead to feelings of fatigue. What is the final, overarching reason behind the link between chronic fatigue and diabetes? The answer is, naturally, reason number 7, nutritional deficiencies. Obviously, the human body requires a wide range of macro and micronutrients, including vitamins, minerals, essential fatty acids, amino acids, and even carbohydrates in order to function optimally. And certain specific nutritional deficiencies can lead directly to chronic fatigue, and being diabetic or insulin resistant can increase your risk of various nutritional deficiencies. Chronic high blood sugar can damage the lining of your small intestine. This can lead to malabsorption, where your digestive system has increased difficulty absorbing proper amounts of nutrients from the foods you eat. Plus, as previously mentioned, high blood sugar can increase urine production, which not only increases the risk of dehydration, it also results in a loss of energy-related nutrients. Specifically, it's been reported that those with diabetes are at an increased risk for anemia, a condition related to being deficient in iron. Iron is essential for the production of red blood cells, which transport oxygen through the body. So naturally, an iron deficiency can decrease your red blood cell production, which in turn may cause your organs and muscle cells to become oxygen deprived. This can then lead to feelings of weakness, lethargy, and fatigue. Speaking of iron deficiencies, diabetes also increases the risk of kidney damage, which can further contribute to anemia, which can then create heightened fatigue. Another nutrient related to energy is vitamin B12, which is also utilized in the production of red blood cells. Being deficient in this essential micronutrient can also lead to weakness, numbness, tingling in the hands and feet, and, of course, chronic fatigue. Also, a malabsorption of magnesium, a mineral involved in energy production and the maintenance of healthy muscle and nerve function, can also create feelings of exhaustion and fatigue. Not receiving adequate amounts of vitamin D can also create weakness, muscle pain, and chronic fatigue. And studies show that being deficient in heart and brain-aiding omega-3 fatty acids can contribute to mood swings, cognitive issues, and fatigue. So there you have it. There are many interconnected reasons why diabetes can lead directly to chronic fatigue. But this doesn't mean that your situation is hopeless. You do not have to spend the rest of your life suffering through the vicious cycle of increased insulin resistance and heightened fatigue. To improve your insulin sensitivity while decreasing your feelings of fatigue, subscribe to a diabetes-fighting diet, regularly including foods high in dietary fiber, lean protein, unsaturated fats, and complex carbohydrates will work to reduce your insulin resistance, your fasting blood sugar, your levels of inflammation, and your feelings of fatigue. Increase your exercise. While being sedentary can only worsen your blood sugar, your weight, and your alertness, being active can create the opposite effect. Stay hydrated. Avoiding dehydration helps to mitigate the risk of heightened insulin resistance and chronic fatigue. Staying hydrated helps to transport oxygen and other essential nutrients throughout your body, which will improve your insulin sensitivity and your alertness. Get good sleep. Being mindful of obtaining 7 to 8 hours of quality sleep each night helps you avoid morning glucose spikes, and it works to keep you awake and alert during the day. Following these steps can aid you in your quest for lower inflammation, decreased blood sugar levels, less oxidative stress, improved nutritional absorption, and a reduction in feelings of anxiety, depression, and fatigue. So, what did you think of today's topic? Do you have any other suggestions for how to decrease chronic fatigue? Comment below to let us know. Before you go, don't forget to grab your 3 free gifts. Simply click the link below to grab them all right away. And please do us a favor by clicking the like and subscribe buttons. And to show even more support for diabetes smarts, you can click the thanks button. We want to thank you for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.